whales are off track. The sea is all shiny, so pretty to see. Black and oily and heavenly. Thank all companies for the care that they take of all of our lovely seas.
Okay, second song.
Which is...
Are we? We're all pissed off, but are we going to sit down and sigh?
No!
We're not! Are we going to hope that Christy Clark changes her mind?
No!
No fear! This is what we've got to do! Okay.
We got to wake up. We need to rise up. We need to open our eyes and do it now. We've got to solve it, get involved and do it now.
An intervener in the National Energy Board pipeline hearings. Please welcome Adam Olson.
Hello, Victoria! My name is Sahanap. I'm from WSANEC. That's right. Our elders sat in front of that panel and they told They opened up their lives. They opened up their hearts. And they were ignored. They were told it didn't matter. Yesterday, it didn't matter. It didn't matter what they said. That they didn't want oil takers expansion through the Salish Sea. The places where we fish. The places where we harvest. Our lives, our livelihoods. Who we are as a people didn't matter yesterday. And don't confuse the words that our Prime Minister said yesterday when he said that this was a decision about science. There was no science, it was all politics. It was all politics. There was no science there, and they certainly didn't listen to the Indigenous people that sat in front of them. They said that a third of the First Nations that they talked to supported it. Pardon me? What about the other two-thirds? We don't matter.
Shame.
We don't matter. I thank you all for coming out this evening. I thank you for standing with us all, those of us, our elders and our communities, our chiefs and our councils that stood there and stood up for us. I thank you for standing with us tonight. And I just ask, don't forget us when we go and fight these pipelines in court. Don't forget us when we take these pipeline, these decisions to court. Please continue standing with us. These are expensive. And I want to just leave you with one thing. Our communities are not wealthy communities. They need not only your physical support standing in squares like this. We need your financial support.
Where's the bucket?
We need you to please open up your wallets. Because we cannot divert these resources to hire lawyers to go and continue fighting. fighting these decisions, these awful decisions in court. We can't go it alone. Yes, we have constitutional rights, but we need you to step up with your wallets as well and support the First Nations like Tsleil-Waututh.